妹们平安。
Peace to all of you, brothers and sisters.
祝大家新年蒙恩。
Wishing you a happy Chinese New Year.
在过去的两年的疫情呢，就打乱了我们的生活的常态。
You know that the last 2 years of pandemic has actually disrupted our normal lifestyle.
也搞乱了我们的传统。
And even actually disrupted our traditions.
那么去年呢，我们因为这个 MCO 啊，这个的行管令，我们都不能够回家过年。
That all of us knew that we couldn't go back to hometown because of the MCO.
那么今年呢，我们就可以回家过年了。
Oh, but this year we can actually return to our hometown.
所以很多弟兄姐妹都回家了。
Therefore, many brothers and sisters have actually returned home.
但是今年我们也面对那个新的常态。
And yet this year we face another new norm.
今年我们不再是跟人家说恭喜恭喜。
We are not going to say congratulations. 恭喜恭喜。
今年我们要说恭喜。
Oh, we're going to show this type of hand gesture.
为什么呢？因为今年是敞开双手之年。
Because this year is the year of open hands.
好不好？跟你左右两边人说恭喜恭喜。
Or to tell the person next to you with this open hand and say 恭喜恭喜 this way.
但是在你在外面的时候就不要这样做了，别人会表错情。
Otherwise, people will misunderstand.
别人以为你要拿红包，而且要拿双份。
People thought you want an angpao, actually want it double.
所以感谢神呢，今年就是其实这个敞开双手，就是君王向我们敞开双手，施恩典给我们，施恩赐给我们。
But this year we knew that it's the gracious hands of the Lord through us, like a king giving us a year of double five.
两个手呢，就是。两个五
that these both hands represent double five.
所以叫做双五之年。
That's why it's called a year of double five.
那么今年呢，今天呢，我就跟大家分享了这个的双五之福。
I'm going to share with you this today is the blessings of double five.
到底双五代表什么的福分呢
？And what does double five means in blessing?
上个星期呢，有一个的弟兄就给我这个的图片。
Last week a brother gave me this.Image.
我觉得蛮有意思
哦。I thought it's quite meaningful.
你看，就是2022的倒影呢，就变成5055。
That the reflection of 2022 is 5055.
2022就是双二。
That we know 2022 is double two.
倒影呢就是5055，就是双五。
And the reflection is double five.
原来这个二跟五呢，是他们是彼此相扣的，彼此的连接。
Now actually, two and five is actually closely related.
也是彼此的导引。
And also reflecting one another.
所以二跟五呢是形影不离的。
Therefore, two and five are closely related.
你看到二，你就看到五。
When you see two, you see five.
所以难怪有人整天叫你说“以五仔，以五仔”。
I know one of those people say you're a traitor, so to say.
其实 对我们个人来说呢，就是你看我跟师母呢两个人就变成一家五口。
That's why 师母 and I that from two become five.
是也是二跟五的这个的恩典，这个的祝福。
And this is the grace and the blessing of two and five.
在圣经里面每一个的数字都有它的意义的。
We know in the Bible every numeric has a value in it.
那么我们今天来看看到底二跟五有什么的属灵的含义呢
？Let us look at two and five, the spiritual meaning of it.
当然它的意思不止这些，但是今天只是简短的讲一讲。
Of course, the meaning does not confine, but I'm going to describe some today.
当然二字它最重要的一个意思就代表连结，就是结合。
And the most important meaning of two is the number of union.
就是二成为一啊
，that two becomes one。
你看，我们知道耶稣有两个的属性啊，但是他有同时有神的属性，也有人的属性。
That we know that Jesus has two types of nature, the divinity and humanity of it。
他是百分之百的神
，he is 100% God。
然而他道成肉身的时候，他成为百分之百的人。
And yet when he becomes flesh, he becomes 100% man。
同时之间呢？出现在一个的个体的身上，就是百分百的神跟百分百的人结合为一。
And yet he appeared in a body form is a relation, a close relation between 100% of human and God.
唯有那圣洁无瑕的神子，神的儿子，而且是一个的完全无罪的人子，才能够把世人从我们的罪里面拯救出来。
Only the 100% holy and unblemished nature of God and also the Son of Man that is combined to rescue us from the bondage of sin.
所以耶稣就是神与人的这个的结合。
Therefore Jesus is a combination of man and God.
但是当然他完全是神，他也是道成肉身，也完全是人。
And yet he's 100% God, and yet he became flesh and became man.
所以在约翰福音的第10章30节，这里说他说，耶稣说：“我与父 原为一。
In John 10:30, say, I and the Father are one.
我们知道神是三位一体的神。
We know that God is the God of Trinity.
圣父、圣子、圣灵。
Father God, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
而耶稣就是在 三位一体的神的第二个的位格，就是二。
And Jesus is the second nature of this Trinity.
所以二其实是代表耶稣在这个三一神的这个的位格。
Therefore, second, two means he's the second one in this nature of Trinity.
那耶稣呢？他与天父原为一，其实是一个神，不是三个神，也不是两个神。
And when he said, "I and the Father are one," that means there's only one God, not three gods.
只是以不同的位格、不同的身份去表现他自己。
And yet he manifests himself in different characters.
那当耶稣他要回到天上之前呢，就是在被出卖的那个晚上，他就为门徒祷告。
And before he was betrayed, the night before, he prayed for the disciples.
他也为所有的信徒，包括我们来祷告。
And he even prayed for all the believers, including us.
他向天父请说，使他们合而为一，像我们合而为一。
He asked of the Heavenly Father that they may be one as we are one.
你看耶稣、哦、他说在前面的一节他说呢，我在父里面，父也在我的里面。
The verse before it says that I'm in the Father and Father is in me.
然后他说使他们呢也合而为一，像我们合而为一。
So that they may be one just as we are one.
所以耶稣在我们的里面，我们也在他们的里面。
And we
我在他的里面
are in Jesus, and Jesus in us, and our Father is in us.
因此我们也在父的里面。
And yet we are also in the Father.
所以借着耶稣我们与神合一。
Therefore to Christ we can reconcile to God.
然后人有两个的性别，你不是男就是女。
And human have two gender, either male or female.
男性与女性。
And male and female.
然后神就是创造一男一女呢，让他们在婚姻中合而为一。
And then God has created a man and woman so they can be made one in marriage.
一男一女的婚姻关系能够生儿育女，延续家庭。
A man and a woman in a marriage can give birth to children and continue the
family. 所以圣经说呢，人要离开父母与妻子呢，二人成为一体。
Therefore the Bible says man and woman shall leave the parents so that unite with the one another.
在以弗所书第五章保罗就说这是预表基督与教会之间的合一。
The Ephesians 5 it says it signifies the union between Christ and the church.
耶稣就好像这个的丈夫、
Jesus、
教会就好像妻子
and the church is the bride
的合一。
That is the union of it.
然后再讲到这个二成为义的，其另一方面就是神所与人立的盟约呢，就分为旧约还有新约两个约。
The two become one is another description. God's agreement with mankind divided into Old and New Testament.
这两个约就成为我们的圣经。
And this Old and New Covenant
became
our Bible, New and Old.
在旧约跟新约有什么不同呢？主要的在旧约呢，人是靠遵行律法而得到祝福，而且是属世的祝福。
The difference between new and old covenants is in the old, earthly blessing came to obedience to the law.
在旧约圣经里面，神告诉以色列的百姓，很多很多的律法，只要你们遵行耶和华的律法，你们就蒙福。
And yet in the New Testament, spiritual blessing comes to submission to Christ.
当然，他们如果不遵行呢，就得不着祝福，而且是落在咒诅的里面。
Or in the old covenant, if they do not obey, they will fall into the curses.
但我们知道，在旧约，所有的人都失败，他们不能够百分百的遵行律法。
And yet in the Old Testament, not everyone can obey the law.
所以，上帝差遣他的独生儿子耶稣基督为我们而来。
Therefore, God sent His only begotten Son.
为我们完成了律法，在十字架上成就了。一切的义
and fulfill the law on the cross so that we can become righteous.
所以今天我们在新约呢，我们是靠着归顺基督，我们心靠基督，
Therefore,
完全
new covenant,
靠着耶稣基督，不是靠我们自己。
It's all by obedience to Christ, not by ourselves.
而且我们所得到的祝福呢，不只是属世的祝福，更重要的是属天的祝福，是永恒的祝福，是属灵的祝福。
And the blessing is not just earthly, but also spiritual blessings.
所以在约翰第一章十七节是说，律法就是旧约，是借着摩西所颁布的，但是恩典和真理呢，却是借着耶稣基督而来的。
Therefore, in John 1 it says, "For the law was given through Moses; grace and truth came through Jesus Christ."
所以今天我们在耶稣基督里，我们就已经得着神为我们预备的恩典真理。
Therefore, in Jesus Christ, we have received grace and truth that is prepared by God.
一切的祝福，而不是靠我们遵行律法。
Therefore, the blessing is not because of us being obedient to the law.
你看 有两个的亚当，圣经也说啊，两个的亚当。
And the Bible also mentioned two Adams.
啊，第一个的亚当呢，他犯了罪。
The first Adam sinned.
结果他就给世界全世界的人带来了死亡和毁灭。
And brought death and destruction into the world.
所以我们看到这个的世界走向这个的灭亡的终局。
Let me know that the world is walking towards the destiny of death.
耶稣来呢，他成为第二个的亚当，幕后的亚当。
Jesus came as the second or the last Adam.
他却带来了复活和永生的希望。
And brings hope of the resurrection and eternal life.
而且有句话说呢，一个人呢、啊，每一个人，如果我们只有一次生，我们就会有两次的死；如果有两次生，就会有一次的死。
There's a famous saying that a man born once will die twice, but born twice will die once.
所以耶稣在约翰福音第三章三节他说呢，人若不重生呢，就不能进神的国。
John 3 that says no one can see the kingdom of God unless he is born again.
你看。一出生就是我们的肉体、啊、肉体出生，我们来到这个世界，我们有生命。
Born once means we are born in the flesh once, then we have life.
所以每个人来到这个世界，你至少是一次的出生。
That every one of us who came here, at least we are born once.
但是如果你只生一次，就会面对两次的死亡。
If you are born once, you will die twice.
一次就是面对肉身的死亡。后来呢，就是那个灵魂永远的灭亡。
The first is your physical body death, but eventually will be a spiritual death.
所以第二次的死就是永远的与神隔绝。
And the second death, you will forever separated from God.
但是如果两次生呢，就会只有一次的死。
But if you're born twice, you will only die once.
两次生就是我们不只是我们肉体生，而且我们呢，接受耶稣的时候，我们就重生。
Born twice means not only we are biological.Birth, but when you accept Jesus, you are born again.
耶稣说，从灵生的就是灵。
Jesus said, you are born in the spirit, you are in the spirit.
灵啊，就能够，我们就可以啊，进到神的国。
And if you are in the spirit, you can enter into the kingdom of God.
所以两次生呢，就只有一次的死，只是肉体的死，而不是灵魂的死。
If you are born twice, you only die once. That means die in the physical, but not in the spiritual.
灵魂是永远的活着。
Your spiritual will continue to live.
当然，当耶稣再来的时候，他会给我们一个复活的身体。
Of course, when Jesus comes again, he will give us resurrected bodies.
所以二的第一个意思，刚才我们说是结合。
Now the first meaning of two is a combination.
但是二同时也是相反的区分分开的意思。
And yet two is also the number for division.
你看圣经里面常常很多的比喻，耶稣讲呢，天国呢、啊、就是天国的王回来的时候，然后他就会分出绵羊与山羊。
And when Jesus when they get parables of the kingdom, he will set these words.
啊，绵羊就是真正属于耶稣基督的门徒，山羊呢就是。不是属于他的。
The sheep represent the disciples of Jesus, and the goats are otherwise.
哦，然后就会分开来。
And it will be separated.
就是一分为二。
That one become two.
然后在一边的田地里面，同时有麦子和麦子一起的长大的。
And even in the same field, there will be growing of wheat and weeds.
所以不一定是说在教会里面的都全是麦子。
It doesn't mean that everyone who remain in church are wheat.
可能也有麦子的存在。
And maybe there existence of weeds.
但我相信啊，新圣灵复兴教会应该全都是麦子啦。
But I believe new life, all of us are wheat.
希望是的。
Oh, let's hope so.
不然被分开来不好了。
And maybe a separator is not a good thing.
然后呢，在提摩太后书，保罗也说呢。
Second Timothy, Paul also mentioned.
在大户的人家有很多种不同的器皿。
In a household, there are different types of vessels.
然后器皿也有分成贵重的器皿，还有卑贱的器皿。
And even vessels are being described as honor and dishonor.
真贵重和卑贱是不是看你呵护神的使用、啊、
The description for honor and dishonor whether you can be used by God、
啊、不是看你是金器、银器、木器、瓦器，而是看你有没有呵护神的使用。
It doesn't matter if you are made of gold or silver but whether you are usable for the kingdom of God。
然后在当然在雅各书他说，心怀恶意的人、啊、double-minded man 就不想我越是要希望从神得到什么。
And in the book of James even mentioned a person who is a double-minded man will not expect anything good from God.
因为耶稣说什么呢，不与我相合的就是敌我的，不同我收据的都是分散的。
Jesus said, he who is not with me is against me and who does not gather with me scatters.
所以一跟二呢，它的两个最重要的一个就是结合，一个就是分开。
For two is either combine or separate or divide.
所以如果我们不是与主连结的，我们就是与他分开的。
Either we are connected with Christ or we are separated from Christ.
是没有中间的。
There's nothing as middle.
然后 第二还有第三个含义就是加倍双倍的意思。
The meaning of two is also the number for doubling.
啊，是除了是结合，除了是分开，还有加倍。
Like、combination or division is also doubling.
啊，我们知道这个的。以利沙的故事哦，
你 know the story Elisha?
他就跟这个求那个他的师父以利亚说，愿感动你的灵加倍的感动我。
And he asked of Elijah, let me inherit the double portion of your spirit.
啊，当然后来呢，真的是以利沙领受了以利亚双倍的恩膏。
And Elijah actually received the double portion of Elijah's spirit.
啊，以利沙所行的神迹呢，也是以利亚所做的双倍。
And the miracles performed by Elijah is double of what performed by Elijah.
你看这个的恩膏是从哪里来的呢？
Where does the anointing come from?
当然是从上帝而来的。
Of course, it came from the Lord.
这个恩膏不是从以利亚来的。
The anointing did not come from Elijah.
但是神却透过以利亚去传杯给以利沙双杯的恩膏。
And yet, this anointing is passed through Elijah to Elisha for this double portion.
以利亚只不过是一个的管道。
Elijah was only a vessel, a channel.
但是为什么以利沙会得着呢？
Why did Elisha inherit?
你看今天我们说神给我们恩典。
Sometimes you say God gave me grace.
我们有些时候我们就觉得理所当然的。
We thought it should be.
神已经要给我了，我就是坐在这边等吧。
Now actually God wants to give me, I just sit there and wait.
但是神耶稣也说天国是要努力进去的。
But Jesus did mention we have to strive to enter the kingdom of God.
不是靠我们努力去得救，但是我们还是要有我们的责任的。
We do not strive to be safe, and yet we do have our portion.
你看这个以利亚，他也有很多很多的门徒。
And Elijah has actually many disciples.
为什么其他的门徒没有得到双倍的恩膏呢？
Why other disciples did not?
为什么只有以利沙得到呢？
Why only Elisha received?
因为以利沙非常的渴慕，他紧紧的追着以利亚。
Because Elijah desired and followed closely with Elijah.
如果你真的要走，求你把双倍的恩膏赐给我。
If you have to leave, please give me the double portion of your.
所以以利亚说，如果你我走的时候你看见就得着，看不见就得不着。
Elijah told him, "If you see me when I leave, you will receive. If not, you will not."
所以以利沙他就非常的渴慕，他就在这边看，劳苦传道、教导的人呢，当以披受加倍的金奉了。
That in Paul and in First Timothy, Timothy, that it says that those who have been labeled in the Lord is worthy of double honor.
但是那些不善于管理的呢
？What about those who are not good in managing?
那些没有劳苦传道教导的人呢
？Those who are not working hard and teaching.
当然就不会得到双倍的这个的
金奉。Of course, we will not receive the double honor.、
啊、所以你看，神是很公平的。
Therefore, God is just.、
啊、所以神为我们预备加倍的，但是我们必须要去承接。
God has actually prepared double portion, but we have to inherit.
神给我们两个手伸敞开来。
Let God give us two hands to stretch out.
然后我们只是用一个手去接。
But we only receive with one hand.
一个手放在口袋里面。
Then another hand put in the pocket.
我们不能够得到双倍的祝福。
We cannot receive double blessing.、
嗯、所以那个是二是主要的含义。
There was two.
那么五呢
？Now it comes to five.、
哦、五就是这个意思，五的意思就是恩典。
Five means grace.
当然也是美善神，美善神的恩惠。
It also means goodness and favor.
圣经中提到318次。
The Bible it has mentioned 318 times.
所以恩典是神为我们预备的。
So grace is what God has prepared for us.
你看恩典是我们基督教信仰跟其他所有世界上宗教最大的一个分别。
And grace is what distinguishes from all other religions.
其他的宗教都是叫你做好人啊，叫你做好事。
The religion teaches how to be.Good man doing good things.
当然，叫做好事做好人肯定是好的。
Of course, doing good things, being good man, they are good.
但是问题是，宗教是靠你要努力去争取。
But religion teaches you to strive to get it.
你要努力去行善，你要靠你的善行，你要靠你的功德。
You must work hard to do good.
你要补偿你的那些的罪孽。
And you have to redeem your sin.
我希望你可以做到某一个的程度，神可以。接纳你，你就得到救恩了。
You can work up to a certain level that God will receive you.
但是那个是人根本不可能做到的事情。
But this is impossible for man to do this.
所以神就给我们一个恩典，就是耶稣基督。
Therefore, God gives us a grace who is Jesus Christ.
以弗所书第二章八节对我们说呢
？Ephesians 2 says,
你们得救，我们的救恩是靠着恩典。
That our salvation is by grace.
我们一起说恩典。
Let us say grace.
你看得救是一个恩典，恩典是什么？就白白赐给我们的，不是我们赚取得来的。
That is grace. Have you been saved? Is something that's given to us freely. It's not something that you work on it.
所以得救是靠着恩典，也是借着信心。
And also, this is also by faith.
信心就是我们要去接受，我们要相信。
Faith is something that we have to receive and believe.
神要把恩典赐给我们，如果我们不去接受，我们没有信心，我们不会得着。
If God gave us grace that we do not have faith, we will not receive.
救恩是如此。
That this is for salvation.
当然，救恩是最重要的了。
And also, it's very important.
其他的神给我们一切的祝福也是恩典，也是我们必须凭信心去接受的。
And also other blessings also we have to receive by faith.
如果你读到圣经神的应许你不相信，
And yet you receive the promises and yet you don't believe.
或者是你是半信半疑，
Or you're just doubting.
如果你听到一篇的信息你觉得很感动，
That you have been moved by one message.
但是你去领受的时候你好像哎呀滴答阿爸。
But when you receive, you couldn't care less.
你没有凭信心去接受。
You did not receive by faith.
是恩典是给了。
Grace has been given to you.
但是你却没有凭信心去领受。
But you did not receive it through faith.
所以得救是恩典，也是借着信心。
Therefore, grace has been received also through faith.
不是出于自己的，而是神所赐的。
It is the gift of God.
我们一起说，是神所赐的。
Let's say together, it is the gift of God.
你的恩典不是我们靠自己，是神赐给我们的。
Grace is not by work, but is given by God.
也不是出于行为。
And also not by work, so that no one can boast.
你看所有的其他的宗教
，that other religions.
我们不批判别的宗教，他们都做好事、行好事都是好的。
We do not condemn because they are all doing good things.
但是如果靠出于行为，是永远不能够赚取救恩。
But if it's by work, you can never earn salvation.
所以得救是靠着恩典，也是信心。
Therefore, you are saved to grace and faith.
你看，当然神给就一个旧约的摩西的十诫就。两个的石牌刻在一个牌上有五戒。
That the Ten Commandments consists of two sets of five commandments.
那么前面的五戒呢，就关注我们对神的关系我们对神如何看待对我们的神他跟他的关系。
The first five relating to our relationship with God.
后面的五戒就是关乎我们与身边的人的关系。
And the second five concern our relationship with other humans.
当然也有人会说，哎，不是前面的四戒。才是跟神有关系吗
？Of course, some will ask. Isn't it the first four relates to relationship with God?
第一节就是什么？不可有别神，除耶和华以外，不可有别的神。
Yep, there's no other god but one.
不可拜偶像。
Do not pray to idols.
不可妄称神的名。
Do not use the God's name in vain.
要守安息日。
And keep the Sabbath.
这个都是跟神有关系的，对吗
？And these are all relating to God.
谁可以告诉我第五节是什么
？Can you tell me what is the fifth commandment?
第五节是什么
？What is the fifth commandment?
孝敬父母
Honor your parents
孝敬父母不是对人吗为什么会是对神呢
Honoring parents isn't it towards men
其实这个第五戒
Actually, The fifth commandment
它是我们对神的最后一戒
Is our last commandment with God
就是在十诫中
In the ten commandments
就是，但是也同时是我们对人的第一戒
And also our first commandment towards men
所以你看这个五戒五戒这个五也蛮有意思的就是双五
has a meaning, there's a double meaning.
因为五呢就是对神的这个的诫命也是对父母这个诫命是天上的父跟地上的父母的结合
And the fifth commandment is also means relationship with God and with earthly parents
在第五戒
In the fifth commandment
为什么呢
Why?
因为父母亲是神在地上的代表
BecauseParents are representative of God on earth.
今天我们说是神赐给我们生命，对不对
？Today we say God gave us life.
但是神怎样赐给你生命呢
？But how did God give you life?
你是从石头包出来的吗
？Do you burst out from the stones?
是通过你的父母把你生下来的。
Actually, to your parents that gave birth.
你看，在你成长的过程中，是谁在保护你？谁在看顾你？谁在供应给你
？In your growing up, who is actually watching and protecting and providing for you?
不管你觉得他们好还是不够好
，No matter they are good or bad.
但是神就是透过你的父母来供应你来保护你
and yet God provide and protect you through your parents and as you grow up
所以如果没有父母今天就不会有你
without your parents you won't be here
所以其实父母是神在地上的代表
therefore parents are representative of God
所以为什么圣经说你要孝敬父母
therefore Bible says honor your father and mother
就是十诫中第一个带应许的诫命
and it's the first commandment with a promise
你孝敬父母呢，就可以使你在神所赐你的地上，日子长久。
And when you honor your parents, your days on earth will be lasting.
但是在你在地上的日子是神所赐给你的。
And your days on earth are days given by God.
但是当你孝敬父母的时候呢，你就领受神迹。
And you will inherit.
所以你顺服父母的权柄，你就得到上帝的祝福。
When you obey the authority of your parents, you will receive.
只有顺服权柄，才会领受权柄。
Only when you submit to authority, you will receive this.
不顺服权柄，就是没有权柄的。
And if you are not submission to authority, you will not have authority.
当这个亚当顺服上帝的权柄，神给他权柄管理全地。
And when Adam submit to the authority of God, God gave him authority to rule.
但是他不顺服上帝的权柄，他就失去了这个权柄。
But when he disobeyed God's authority, he lost the authority.
他顺服在魔鬼的权柄之下，所以活在这个撒旦的权柄之下。
He submit to the authority of Satan and live under the Satan's authority.
所以父母亲就代表这个的地上属灵的权柄。
Therefore, parents represent the earthly authority.
当然，父母亲的责任也很重大哦。
Of course, their responsibilities
are great. 你要知道啊，你是代表神的哦。
You're representing God.
哦，你不要回去告诉你孩子，你看我要好像看神啊。
Don't tell your children that when you look at me, you're looking at God.
哎，像你要审一下我有没有好好的代表神。
You'll probably examine ourselves. Am I representing God?
因为他们看不到天父，他们看不到你。
Because they can't see Heavenly Father, but they can see you.
Amen.所以这个就是第五戒，就是
在
第五戒里面，人对神的责任跟人对人的责任结合在第五戒。
It's the relationship of God and man is a combination.
当我们真正明白旧约律法的严厉，我们不可能去成就，我们才会体会到恩典是多么的珍贵。
It's only when you have a true understanding of the strict requirements of the law that will lead to a deep appreciation of grace.
我们以为恩典是白白赐给我们的吗？
Because grace is freely given to us.
你看，人是这样的，得到恩典的时候，他觉得理所当然。
That humans are like that. When we receive grace and it's freely given, we thought it should be so.
当他失去恩典的时候，
但 when he lose it,
他就大发牢骚。
And he will be angry.
为什么？
Why?
为什么
？Why?
因为他觉得是应该的。
Because he thought it should be.
当人认为恩典是应该的时候，我们就会不会感恩。
And when man thinks that grace is something that should receive, we will not be thankful.
当我们认为恩典是应该的，我们得不着的时候，我们就会埋怨。
And we think that grace that we should receive and we don't, we will complain.
所以当我们真正知道恩典我们才会珍惜恩典。
And when we know grace, then we will treasure grace.
恩典当然那个五，刚才我们讲恩典这部分，当然也是恩赐。
And just now we talk about grace, now we talk about the gift.
就是也是代表五种的恩赐。
That you know there's a fivefold gift.
当然恩赐不只是有五种啊。
Of course, gift will not limited to five.
在圣经里面至少列出27种的恩赐。
That in the Bible there's at least 27 gifts of the Holy Spirit.
当然也不只是27种啊，圣经说我们也要有百般的恩赐。
That not only 27, the say the fivefold.
五种的恩赐是要造就教会的恩赐。
But this fivefold ministry is to build the church.
神是给使徒、先知、传福音的、牧养的、教导的。
And apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers.
要建立基督的身体。
To prepare God's word and His body.
所以总结来说，双五呢就是什么呢？五就是恩典哦。
In conclusion,
双五就是加倍的恩典。
Grace is number five is grace, so double five means grace upon grace.
就是恩典再加上。
Grace upon grace.
双份的恩典。
Double five, double grace.
你看在约翰。福音第一章他说，从他的丰盛里，从耶稣基督的丰盛里，我们都领受，我们是领受的，我们不是赚取的，而且是恩上加恩。
That from the fullness of His grace we have received, all receive one blessing after another.
然后接下来的就是刚才我们看到那个经文，就是说律法是借着摩西颁布的。
As you have seen earlier, the law was given to Moses.
是靠着人的努力去遵行的。
That you have to strive to.
是无论你怎样尝试都不能够满足的。
But no matter how hard you try, you cannot fulfill.
恩典和真理却是借着耶稣基督白白赐给我们。
Yet grace and truth came to Jesus Christ, given to me freely.
所以 double five 其实就是恩上加恩的意思。
Therefore, double five means grace upon grace.
不要只是会说 double five， 你要知道它的意思。
Do not just mention double five. You must know the meaning of it.
最后用两段的经文来总结。
Conclude these two Bible verses.
你看，在以赛亚书61章呢，就讲到预言呢，神会给末后会这是他的子民所预备的祝福。
That Isaiah 61 is what God has prophesied for the blessing in the days to come.
所以在第前面七节，当然很多祝福了，我只是冲几节。
Of course, there are many. There are just select a few.
第一节说呢， 主耶和华的灵在我的身上，因为耶和华的高了我，叫我传福音给困苦的人，差遣我去医治伤心的人，向被掳的宣告自由，向被囚的宣告释放。
The first one, they say, the Spirit of the Lord is on me because the Lord has anointed me to preach good news to the poor.
然后呢，就宣告耶和华悦纳人的喜悦。
Claim the year of the Lord's favor.
然后跳到第三节，就是说，神会赐给我们喜乐，油代替一切的悲哀。
Verse 3 says, the oil of gladness instead of mourning.
赞美乐代替沮丧的灵。
Yeah, I'm not praising the spirit of despair.
不管你是过去如何的悲哀，如何的沮丧，神要代替。
No matter how sad or despair you are, God will replace it.
然后你被称为公义的香树，是耶和华栽种的。
Of righteous planting of the Lord.
你看，你是公义，不是靠你自己，是神亲手栽种的。
The righteous is not because of you, but it's planted by the Lord.
好使神他自己得着荣耀。
That there will be a display of His glory.
然后跳到第七节
，Verse 7，
就说你们，他们必得加倍的份。
You will receive a double portion.
代替你们所受的羞愧，过去是羞愧的。
Instead of disgrace that is in the past,
现在你要加倍的祝福。
Now you may receive
double portion. 神要偿还你加倍的偿还你。
That God will repay you with this double.
让你欢呼，代替羞辱。
That you will rejoice instead of disgrace.
你必拥有加倍的产业。
And you will receive a double portion.
必有永远的喜乐，阿门。
And your joy will be everlasting. 弟兄姐妹，
好不好？
Do you want to receive such a blessing that it will be fulfilled?
你看这段的经文，就是当耶稣。他来自世上道成肉身，他在拿撒勒讲的第一篇的信息。
And the first message delivered by Jesus in Nazareth is based on these words.
他就翻开这个以赛亚书，他就读这节。
And he turned open the book of Isaiah. He read these verses.
在路加福音的四章十八节。
Luke 4:18 says.
所以耶稣就说，然后讲完的时候，他就对身边的人说。
And after he has mentioned, he told everyone around him.
这些的应许今天要实现在你们中间。
This has been fulfilled among you.
所以当耶稣来的时候呢
？Therefore, when Jesus came,
这些以赛亚说的应许，加倍的祝福。
And these promises mentioned in the Isaiah double portion,
成为神的公义。
That it will be oaks of righteousness.
不是我们靠自己的义。
Not through our own righteousness.
这些都成就了。
And all these are being fulfilled.
所以弟兄姐妹，我们必须紧紧的相信。
Therefore, brothers and sisters, we must.
我们不相信，我们就得不着。
If you do not believe, you will not receive.
我们看不见，我们就得不着。
If you do not see, you will not receive.
我们不是不凭眼见，我们要用信心的眼睛看见。
We don't live by what we see, but we see with the eyes of faith.
我们用信心的眼睛看见神的应许。
We must see with the eyes of faith of these promises.
我们可以相信，我们可以坦然无惧的来到神的面前。
We must believe and come boldly before the Lord.
因为我们已经领受了耶稣基督为我们成就。
Because we have received righteousness,
我们可以得到加倍的祝福。
Jesus, we must receive the double portion.
我们可以拥有加倍的产业。
We must have double portion in our inheritance.
最后一个经文。
Therefore, the last verse.
刚才是旧约，这个是新约。
This one was in Old Testament or in the New Covenant.
第五章十五节。
And Romans 5:15.
保罗说。恩赏和过犯是截然不一样的。
That Paul said, gift is not like the trespass.
不只是。不截然不同啊，而且是过犯。这个和合本说，过犯是不如，过犯是比不上恩赐的。
That not only is different, but it says the trespass cannot even compare to grace.
如果因着那一个人的过犯，众人都死了。
If many died by the trespass of the one man,
那一个人是谁？就是亚当。
And who's that man? Adam.
亚当的罪严重不严重
？How serious was Adam's sin?
非常的严重啊
！Very serious.
因为不只是他一个人死，所有的人都要跟他一起死。
Because not only he died, everyone have to die because of him.
而且世世代代，每一世代的人都因为他的过犯，我们都要死。
And generationally, we have to die because of him.
所以亚当的过犯非常的严重。
Therefore, the trespass of Adam.
因着他的过犯，众人都死了。
Because of his trespass, everyone has to die.
但是神的恩典。
But because of the grace of God.
和这一个人成为人的耶稣基督。
The one man, Jesus Christ.
在他恩典里面的赏赐。
By the grace of.
对众人，对所有的人都更加的丰盛了。
That.All of us will receive this gift and grace.
和合本说是加倍的临到众人。
It says it will be overflowing.
所以我们看到亚当的过犯是非常的严重。
And we know that the sins of Adam was very serious.
但是耶稣基督的赏赐，他的恩典是远远的超过这个的过犯。
Yet the grace and gift of Jesus overflowed.
不只是除去我们的罪。
Not only Jesus remove our sins.
叫我们不至于灭亡。
So that we will not perish.
在不用灭亡的当上面，他还加上恩典。
Not only we will not perish, he adds to us his grace.
所以是恩上加恩。
Therefore, his grace upon grace
是丰盛的。
Is overflowing.
是超过我们所求所想的。
It's beyond what we can also imagine, brothers and sisters.
今天我们抓不抓到这个的真理？
Have we received this truth?
今天我们来到神的面前，我们坦然无惧。
Today we come boldly before the Lord.
是因为你觉得你自己很好呢？
Do you think that you are good enough?
是因为你觉得你自己很圣洁呢？
Or you think you're holy?
是因为你觉得自己很爱神呢？
Or you think that you love the Lord?
当然这些都重要了。
Of course, these are important.
你看我们说行为不重要，不是说 我不是说行为不重要，我们是说
I'm not saying behaviors are not important.
我们不能够靠行为去得救恩。
We cannot be saved through our works.
但是得到救恩之后，我们要不要有行为？
But after receiving grace, don't we need characters?
行事为人要与这个的蒙召的恩相称啊。
Now, when we believe, we have to be incomparable with the grace that we receive.
所以先有蒙召的恩，才有行事为人。
Only when you have received grace,
所以行事为人不是一个的得救的途径，而是一个的结果。
To live is not the way to get salvation, but
但是今天我们领受祝福
，but today
绝对不是靠我们的
receive blessing, not through works.
我们只是来到主的面前。
Today we come before the Lord.
我们不看自己。
Do not look at ourselves.
我们不看自己配不配。
Whether we are worthy or not.
我们只是单单仰望耶稣。
That we just look to Jesus.
唯有他叫我们配的，我们一起站起来。
Because
我们一起来祷告，我们一起敬拜团队。
To be worthy.
哈利路亚，感谢耶稣。
Amen. Praise the Lord.
我们仰望主耶稣，唯有他是我们生命的主。
Look at the Lord. He is the Lord of our life.
唯有他是我们生命的所有。
And he is the Lord of all.
唯有他是我们生命的全部。
And he is.
唯有是他我们生命的中心。
That he's the center of our life.
感谢耶稣。Amen. 好，我们举起手来对主说。
Even as he raised our hands,
耶稣，我单单的仰望你。
Lord, I just look to you.
是主啊，我单单需要你。
Lord, I only need you.
是主啊，你坐在我心中的宝座。
That is
the throne
of my heart. You are the king.
没有任何的人可以取代。
Nobody else can replace you.
没有任何的事物可以取代。
Nothing can replace you.
是主啊，因为你是我的神。
Yes, Lord, because you are my.